What's up, everyone? So Canon just announced the amazing EOS R5, which is a 45 megapixel full frame, no crop, mirrorless camera that is capable of shooting 8K 30 frames per second, including RAW. That camera has so many groundbreaking features that it stunned everybody. It pretty much killed the excitement many people had for the Sony a7S III, but not for me. But Sony, how long do we have to wait for it? If you see my videos, you know that I've been shooting with the Sony a7 III for quite a while, and I still love using it. The Sony a7 III is a 24 megapixel full frame mirrorless camera that is capable of shooting 4K 30 frames per second, and with a buttery smooth 120 frames per second at 1080p. When Sony announced this camera, I immediately knew that I had to get one, or even two now, of these cameras. I actually made the full switch from my Canon 80D to the Sony a7 III. The Canon 80D is a really great beginner's camera. I actually regret selling it because I had such great memories with it. It's a 24 megapixel APS-C camera that shoots 1080p at 60 frames per second. At some point, I wanted to pursue videography as a profession and made the upgrade to the Sony a7 III because I knew that I would get a lot of bang for the buck. Till today, I still find I have made the right decision. I've shot some incredible videos with it and I have been very satisfied with the image quality. Of course, there are cons to this camera, as with every camera. I actually made a video about this a while ago, which I will leave a link up here, talking about the Sony a7 III, if it's still worth buying in 2020. As for now, what I don't like about it is the back screen. First of all, it doesn't have a flip out mechanism and has only 922 dot resolution on a screen, whereas the EOS R has almost twice the resolution. Also, the 8-bit codec is pretty average and could be updated to at least 10-bit or even better RAW. I wish it had 4K 60 frames per second just to also have 4K in slow motion. Hands down, the Sony a7 III is by far the best hybrid camera at this point of time for its price. The great news is for those that don't own a Sony a7 III, the price will probably drop with the official release of the Canon EOS R5. That is good because the Sony a7 III is still pretty damn good for a few years to come. You get a lot of features packed in for a really good price. If you are a Sony a7 III user, then I would recommend waiting for the Sony a7S III and the a7 IV announcement, if there ever would be an announcement. I'm pretty sure that Sony will come out with a great camera that's not as crazy as the EOS R5, but will still be worth upgrading, hoping that they will solve most of the issues I've mentioned. So I will be holding my breath for that. But I can't hold my breath forever, Sony. In the end, it's not really about the perfect camera because perfect cameras don't exist. What matters most is that the camera serves you well for your production needs. If you need 8K RAW and have a computer that can handle it, then go for the EOS R5. I pretty much record always in 4K, and I know for sure that I don't need 8K, which is pretty overkill, especially with the huge file size. But it's crazy to imagine that you could use a small mirrorless camera like the EOS R5 that costs roughly $4,000 and shoot 8K in public and nobody would even notice it. Before, if you wanted to record 8K RAW, you had to get like a cinema camera that can shoot 8K, like the Red Weapon, that costs around $24,000. This is just mind-blowing. I'm really happy that Canon brought such a powerful camera into the marketplace, pushing other companies to do the same. So these were my thoughts and reasons for not switching to the EOS R5. Let me know in the comment section below what you think about the EOS R5. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel so that I can keep create these videos for you guys. Follow me on Instagram at Bennett Grazer. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video.